Hello there, welcome back to The Closet Historian. Today I want to talk to you all about my summertime vintage style essentials, the essentials in my retro wardrobe that I pull out every year when it gets warm outside again finally, when finally the summer and the green and everything returns, which is just about what's happening here in Colorado right about now. We don't really get our greenery back until about this time. We don't really get much of a spring here, usually. I have made a couple of essentials videos here on the channel, including one like detailing my six must-have classic essential vintage style pieces in my wardrobe, so I'll put a card up to that video as well. And then just last week I made a video about my essential accessories, or how I collect accessories, vintage style accessories that is, so I'll put a card to that video here as well. If I can do two cards that quickly in quick succession like that, we'll see. I'm not really sure if YouTube will support that, but we'll try it. If not, the links will be in the description and of course just on my uploads page. And the first item on my list of summer essentials is of course going to be big huge straw hats. As we all know here on this channel, if you've been around at all, if you've been on my blog at all, you know I love a big straw hat, especially my big red straw hat. I just adore this hat. This one I did pick up on eBay. The way I find these hats is to just search straw hat and then search until I find this particular style. I'm not sure if these big shallow crowned hats have a particular name. I've heard them referred to as cartwheel hats or halo hats. Sometimes if the crown is open, sometimes you can find these with the open crown on them. But I don't really think they have a specific name anymore. The 18th century, they were called bergère hats. Bergère hats? I don't know how to say this French word. I will put it here on the screen for you. I know that they had a name. This kind of shallow crown pancake style hat had a name in the 18th century. I'm just not sure what they were called in the 30s and 40s when they seemed to be quite popular again, and also in the 50s as well. But the 50s ones seem to be a little bit more domed or curved. I do have a couple of those as well. I'm a big collector of hats, but I just love straw hats in the summertime. I think they are really good for keeping the sun off your face as well as just looking quite chic. And so they're my number one essential for summer, really, is big straw hats. I just adore them. The second summertime essential on my list is going to be a white cotton eyelet dress. For the longest time, I didn't wear white in general, just because I thought if black was slimming, that I should probably avoid white, but that was silly and part of a larger complex I had to get over, and luckily I have, because now my white summer eyelet dress is probably one of my favorite dresses in my whole closet, and I look forward to wearing it in the warmer months when I can get away with wearing such a lightweight dress. And of course, that's one of the perks of an eyelet dress, is it is so lightweight, crisp, and airy in the summertime. You can style this in a very dainty feminine way. You can style it more graphic with like darker navy or black accessories. I wear mine often with red. I just love having a white summery eyelet dress in my wardrobe now. It just looks so crisp, feels so fresh in the summertime. And of course, in a cotton, it's really great. You can just throw something like this in the wash, which is always important when it's the middle of July and you might have gotten a little sweaty browsing that, you know, flea market or whatever. So you want to be able to throw these kinds of things in the wash. So having a white cotton eyelet dress is such an essential for me now. I can't believe I lived so long without one, and I just adore having this one in my wardrobe now. I would like to have more even. The third item on my summer essentials list is going to be another dress, this time a tropical print dress. I have personally many a tropical print dress just because it's a style I quite like. I really like tropical prints in general, as you guys know if you watched my dad shirt video recently, all where I was styling a Hawaiian shirt in many, many ways, because I just love a Hawaiian print, what can I say? But this tropical dress here is just a lightweight cotton one that I made a couple years ago. I do have this same dress in another cotton print as well. I'll put an image of that one here. And then I have a couple of rayon tropical print dresses. Cottons and rayons is pretty much what I stick to for these. Tropical and like Hawaiian or tiki dresses and style is actually quite popular within the pinup and rockabilly community in general. So the repro market does often make dresses like these or tropical print dresses every year. So check out places like Collective, Vivian of Holloway, Unique Vintage. They're usually going to have options in a similar style to this in at least a tropical print. So you can find one that works for you. The fourth item on my list is going to be a wicker handbag. I just think this is such a classically mid-century style. They're so like fun. Something about them just is like picnic baskety, and there's just like a level of novelty to them that I find really nice in the summertime, especially. It just, you know, something a little bit more fun when the sun is out, you know? I don't know. I have many of them, as you can see here. I have a black one, a white one, and then a couple of different natural colored ones. I'd love to have, of course, again, collect them in every color of the rainbow, because we know me. I love to fill out my sets, so of course I still need a navy blue wicker bag and a red one and pink and yellow, and there's many colors I could add to this in the future that I hope to add to this in the future, but of course just a standard natural colored straw wicker bag I think is a really great summer essential for anybody, and certainly is one for me. And switching back over to clothes for my next item, another essential for me are going to be safari style shirts or blouses. Basically anything in an ivory to tan, khaki, anything in between there, and either rayon, silk, cotton, any type of material, but just a very like safari styled blouse. Things that I could like roll up the cuffs with tabs on the sleeves, or things with like patch pockets. Just very classic safari style shirts. Like a shirt with a little bit something extra that pushes it over into like adventurer or like traveler safari style. It's a style that I really wear heavily in the summertime, so having a very classic safari shirts and blouses like these for me are quite an essential in my wardrobe in general, just because this is a style I lean towards so much. This one I'm showing here is actually from Banana Republic, which was for a time a very safari oriented store at their start. And if you ever want to get some like really great safari or adventurer style inspiration, go look up old Banana Republic catalogs on Pinterest and stuff like that, because their catalogs and their clothes used to be so much cooler than they are now, at least if you're like me and you love safari style. The sixth item on my list are going to be my cotton twill little short-sleeved suits. Now, I say this with hesitation because I've had a lot of requests for the pattern number for what I use to make these, or like where you can get them, and I'm really sorry to say that like I make my own sewing patterns, so I made the patterns for these myself, and I don't have any way to size those or grade them, get them scanned or anything. I don't really have any way of manufacturing my own sewing patterns for either digital download or physical sale yet. It's something I really would like to work towards, having my own pattern line someday. I just am not there yet. So I feel almost, you know, bad recommending these suits as one of my essentials, because there's no way for you to really get them from me, or I have no way to recommend anywhere for you to find them, basically. Of course, you can take commercial sewing patterns, suit patterns almost, and just make them in twill, make them with short sleeves, have a seamstress make a suit like this, or you can sometimes find them vintage, but no one is reproducing them as much as far as I know. So I do feel bad recommending these as one of my essentials, but I just wanted to be honest in this list, and mine are quite an essential for me in the summertime. I'm sorry for those of you who do not or cannot sew. I don't know how else to acquire these other than to make them yourself right now, but again, hopefully one day not only will I have a pattern line, but also a reproduction clothing line, in which case I will offer these for sale. But we're just not there yet, you guys. If you, again, as usual, as I always say, if you are a millionaire or you know one who wants to invest in my reproduction things, do reach out. Email me, contact me somehow. I'm happy to get started anytime anyone wants to provide that capital. And returning to a few more accessories just to round out the end of this list, I of course want to recommend flower hair combs. They are a major essential for me in my spring and summer wardrobe and hairstyling for my spring and summer needs. I love having a flower hair comb or two on hand just to either, you know, hide one side of my hair if it's not working out, or if the humidity and my curls are not getting along. But of course, just in general, they're a very fun accent. I think flowers in the hair work all the time. I even like the idea of using perhaps fresh flowers for a special occasion. I think that would be really fun to actually go out and buy real flowers and pin them into your hair. I can imagine that would smell divine as well. I've never tried it, but a real flower crown I feel like would be very fun. But these hair combs I'm showing you here, or hair clips actually in this case, are from a brand called Alternate Normality. I just really like the way that she arranges the flowers and like how they fall and frame the face. I will link to her shop in the description below, but of course you can DIY these. These are quite easy to make. Just plug in your hot glue gun and go to town, really. But I just really love flowers in the hair for summer. It's definitely an essential style accessory for me. And my last summer vintage style essential are going to be my heeled sandals. Of course, I prefer a high heel. It's totally accurate to have a flat sandal or flat shoe year-round with vintage style. They definitely had like ballet flats and all different kinds of flats. I'll put some different catalog pages here on the screen to show you some of the flat styles that were definitely popular in the 40s and 50s, but I just personally prefer a heel, so I like having heeled sandals and open-toed shoes in the summertime. They're an essential for me basically in my wardrobe. Probably these red bait heels are my most worn version of this like style, or this item. I probably wear my red ones the most, just because, as we know, I love my red accessory set. I think you can pair that with anything. Red is a vintage neutral in my opinion, so my red ones probably get the most use, but I have ivory and tan and black, different pairs of open toed or like peep toe sandaled heels for summertime. So they're definitely a huge essential within my wardrobe and something that I wear all summer long every summer. So those are my vintage style summer essentials within my own wardrobe. Of course, you must have your own essentials, so please do tell me what is your most summer essential summer item in your own wardrobe in the comments below. And then do leave me any other essential videos you would like, or ideas for essentials style videos that you'd like, just because I do like making this style of video for you all, but I won't make it another seasonal one until fall. I probably will make that closer to fall just to remain seasonally relevant here. If you have any other essentials you would like me to talk about, please do leave that in the comments below. And thank you, as always, for tuning in today. I'll see you again soon. Bye.